Today, let's talk about, I'm going to talk about letting Swift River go. Like, in this book, I think that this book has a very strong feeling. I think that she is kind of in love of this place because, like, when they have that problem, like, the problem is, like, that in a place, like, in America, a place, there's, like, a city that's thirsting to death, and, like, they need to give water to that place, and then, like, once she's opening the dam so the water can flow to that city, like, she lost everything, and, like, she even lost her friend, and, like, I think really sad for her. And this is the part where the dam got floated, and, like, and this is the part where, like, everyone gathered to the church and talk about it. This is what happened to the place. And at last, she heard her mom said, "You have to let them go." Like, she heard her mom said that, so she did.
What's happening so far in the story?
I'm really sad, and this is about a real story, and it happened really like long ago, 1900, and her name is and this is her friend, and like in the summer this is what they do, and that, then one day, like, they all gather to the church, talk about it.
What are we learning about the character?
I'm learning about a character that she's feeling really sad about her friend, house, and, like, this place that she has been for a long time.
Where in the story can you envision Strong?
I can envision strongly, like, at the end, when she and her dad rowed the boat out to the river. So then at night, she touched the river. That made me envision strongly.
Is there a time where you could feel the character's feelings?
Yes. All through the book, I'm always feeling how the character is feeling by showing like what is happening.
Are you shifting your thinking about the character?
Yeah, because kind of, because like at the beginning she's like having a really like fine life, and then when they started to gather in the church, like I shifted my thinking that there's something going to happen. Then like when I read the next page, I know that like everything is changing so fast.
Can you predict where the story will go from?
Yeah. Because like the author told us that they're like the problem about like the city 60 miles away, and I already know that that's going to happen, so I can envision it.
Do you have any wonderings or anything else you want to discuss about the story? think that this story is really touching story, and I really feel for the assignment because he was from going to a line. When Sheldon Russell Curtis was released from jail after months later, he became great grandfather and left jail on some details. What's happening so far in the story? That there was a war between the states and it was bad, and this Sheldon got shot in the knee and he fell.
Can you show what like in the picture?
Okay. Is there a time where you could feel the character's feeling?
Yes, I could feel it all through the story, how hurt it would be, how scary, how worried.
Are you shifting your thinking about the character?
No, not really. I always kind of thought that.
Can you predict where the story will go from
here? Yeah, I can. I think that they will get caught, but one of them will survive.
Do you have any wonderings or anything else you want to discuss about the story?
No.
My book is Aunt Fossey's Hat and Crab Cake Spear, and I infer that Susan and Sarah likes to go to Aunt Fossey's house because in the cover page they were playing around with Aunt Fossey, and I think Aunt Fossey has a lot of good memories and bad memories. For example, right here, she's talking about the hat and there's the wire thing going on, and this is her when she was young, so. And another good memory is when this happened, and it was funny, and he rescued the hat. And I think the crab cake is really yummy and delicious food for Aunt Fossey, Susan, and Sarah, because they said, "I like what happened next," and what happened next was they're eating the crab cake at the end, right here, they are eating crab cake.
What's happened so far in the story?
So they went to Aunt Fossey's house, and she is telling the story about her life with the hat.
What are we learning about the character?
At first, I thought she was a really lonely and sad person because. At the cover, she was not really smiling that much, and she looked old. But when I read the book, she was kind of funny, and she was good at telling stories. where in the story can you envision Strong?
When this part, when there was fire, like she was worried and she was like hugging her mother, I think. So I can
Is there a time where you could feel the character's feelings?
Yes, when this happened, I could feel the character's feeling because it would be sad if you can't get the hat.
Are you shifting your thinking about the character?
Yeah, kind of. Because at first I thought they were really girly and stuff, but when they were like running around, I noticed that they were really active and such things.
Can you predict what the story will go from here?
I think the story will go some dog will. The hat will fall in the water, and her friend's dog will rescue kind of the hat.
Do you have any wonderings or anything else you want to discuss about this?